This week, we want to teach you a classic dish from Fuzhou, lychee pork, that is, Fujianese-style sweet and sour. We'll be covering two versions. First, a simple homestyle version with potatoes, and also a fancier banquet version that really does kind of look like a dead ringer for lychees. Now, I know that we haven't done a ton of Fujian food on this channel yet, but if you are the type of person that really enjoys that saucy, sour and sweet American Chinese takeout kind of fare, you are going to love the food from Fuzhou. See, it's well known that the bulk of Chinatowns in America were built by Cantonese immigrants, so it naturally follows that a ton of different dishes on that takeout menu have Cantonese roots and equivalents. That said, something that's always bugged me is just how different Cantonese food at large feels on a philosophical level. But besides Guangdong, emigres from the neighboring Fujian province have also had a pretty huge impact on trans-Pacific trade and migration, either directly or via Taiwan and Southeast Asia. And in my personal opinion, at least, the food in Fuzhou just feels, I don't know, closer. They've got hot and sour soup, the mandatory saucy vegetables, their own sort of fried spring rolls, and, of course, sweet and sour pork. Now, obviously, that's not to say that the two foods are an exact one-to-one match or anything, but to me at least, it's hard not to notice some of the philosophical similarities. So, the basis, then, for a Fujianese sweet and sour will be, of course, the vinegar. See, Fujian is a province that's known for its vinegars. After all, their famed Yongchun vinegar is considered one of the big four vinegars in the country. In their sweet and sour, the type of vinegar that's generally used is the Fujianese xiangzu, which refers to a lighter rice vinegar. To sub the stuff, our recommendation would be to use a Japanese rice vinegar, which hits a lot of the same notes. So, let's do the basic homestyle sweet and sour first. To make the sauce, to a bowl, toss in 25 grams of sugar, 25 grams of your rice vinegar, 50 grams of water or stock, a half teaspoon of chicken bouillon powder if you're not using stock, a quarter teaspoon of salt, and 5 grams of soy sauce. Then just give that a quick mix and set your sauce aside. Now, something that we really love about this Fujianese homestyle sweet and sour is the inclusion of these deep-fried potato chunks. So here, we're going to be using 300 grams worth of potato. Just slice it into 1-inch sheets, then into sticks, and finally into chunks. And just like how you always would when prepping potatoes for frying, rinse off a bit of that surface starch, fill your bowl up with water, and let that soak till you're ready to fry. Now for the pork. Here we're going to be using 325 grams of loin. Just give it a slice into about 1/2 centimeter sheets, then take each piece and give it a quick pound with the back of your knife to help loosen up some of the fibers. Then make some shallow cuts in a crisscross pattern, and cut each piece in half at about a 30-degree angle to get something that looks vaguely triangular-ish. Then just marinate those pieces with a 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/2 teaspoon sugar, 1/4 teaspoon baking soda, 1/8 teaspoon white pepper powder, and 1/2 teaspoon liaozhu, aka Shaoxing wine. Give that a real good mix and set it aside. Now to coat for frying. This dish generally uses a basic wet cornstarch coating. To make it, in a bowl, mix together 45 grams of cornstarch together with 35 grams of water. After mixing, it should come together into that sort of non-Newtonian oobleck kind of mixture, so adjust if needed to get this sort of consistency. Then add that to the marinated pork, give it a quick mix, add in 1 tablespoon of water to thin it out a touch, and mix well to make sure everything's evenly coated. Then once coated, we can shape. What we're aiming for here is going to be a rough bowl-like shape. To make it, pull one vertex of your little triangle in, then pinch another on top of that, then wrap the remainder up and over the top. Slightly pinch the sides, and you've got yourself a little ball. Of course, these guys won't exactly be airtight or anything, which is basically the point. The cracks let the oil get inside and will help the pork cook evenly. So, to fry, get a pot of oil up to about 130 centigrade and drop in your pork balls. Give those a fry at 130 for about 3 minutes, or until the pork is fully cooked, then remove and get the oil up to about 195. Drop them in again, fry for about 15 seconds, then take them out. Same deal with those potatoes. First fry once at a low temperature, here I'm also doing 130 for 5 minutes, then up the heat to 195 and drop them in for about 30 seconds and remove. And now, we can fry up our sweet and sour. So, to stir fry, as always, first long yao. Get your wok piping hot, shut off the heat, add in the oil, here about 1.5 tablespoons of peanut, and give it a swirl to get a nice nonstick surface. Now add in 1 clove of minced garlic, swap your flame to high, and toss in the white portion of two scallions. Fry for about 15 seconds till fragrant, then go in with your sweet and sour sauce from before. Now just leave that going over a high flame until everything's starting to bubble rapidly, stirring often, about 30 seconds. Then go in with a slurry of a half tablespoon cornstarch mixed with an equal amount of water. Quick mix, in with the potatoes and the pork. Another quick mix, shut off the heat, drizzle in a teaspoon of toasted sesame oil, brief stir, and out. Optional touch of julienne carrot for garnish, and your homestyle lychee pork with potato is done. Now, the fancy banquet version will differ in two main ways. First, instead of being fried with root vegetable, it's stuffed, most classically with water chestnut. And second, as astute observers among you might have started to gather, that sauce is, well, it's a lot redder. See, in Fujian, you'll see that same red color in a few different dishes, and it's accomplished with this ingredient, hongzao. This stuff is the lees from making a Fujianese style of sticky rice wine, and here we're going to be using 5 grams worth and mixing it with 40 grams of water. And that is going to be the base liquid of the sauce. That said, unfortunately, I don't think hongzao is available outside of China, so our suggested sub would be to take one drop of red velvet, mix that with 5 grams of Shaoxing wine, and top that off with the same 40 grams of water. It's obviously not exactly the same, but I promise it'll do the trick in the end. Either way, to that base, just add in 20 grams of sugar, 20 grams of rice vinegar, a quarter teaspoon salt, 5 grams soy sauce, and a half teaspoon chicken powder if you're not using stock. Give that a real good mix, and your sauce is good to go. Next difference, that water chestnut. Here we've got 12 water chestnuts that we'll need to shave into 24 small little balls for wrapping. But word of warning, this step is an undeniable pain. It's probably the reason why this variant makes a whole lot more sense in a fancy restaurant context. So if you are making this version, do check out an uncut close-up of the process up here. Just take your time working through all those water chestnuts, and then we can wrap. So, this coating is a little different. First, mix 50 grams of cornstarch together with an optional half tablespoon of pounded red yeast rice and 60 grams of water. That red rice is just used for coloring, so if you can't find it, feel free to just toss in a half a drop of red velvet instead. Mix well and set that aside. Now, to wrap these, take both a piece of pork and a chestnut ball and thoroughly coat the two of them. Place the water chestnut in the center, and a bit like the homestyle kind, pull one vertex of your vaguely triangle-like object to the center, pinch another on top of it, and finally roll the remainder up and over and slightly pinch the sides. Then transfer your ball over to a plate of dry cornstarch and roll the loose side around a bit to sort of seal everything up. Work through your pork, and then we can fry. So, pretty much the same deal as a homestyle sort. Fry number 1 at 130 for 3 minutes, then fry number 2 at 195 for 15 seconds. Dip out the oil, do a quick longyao with a tablespoon of oil, but here we'll be forgoing the aromatics and directly frying the sauce. High flame, about 30 seconds till everything's rapidly bubbling, then hit it with a slurry of a teaspoon of cornstarch mixed with an equal amount of water. Once that's good and thickened, go in with the pork balls and give that another quick mix. Heat off, teaspoon of toasted sesame oil, another quick mix, and out. Optionally garnish with a bit of something green, and with that, you've got yourself some fancy Fujianese lychee pork.
So we chose to stuff this one, but there's another totally traditional and legit method, which is just deep frying the water chestnut together with the pork. But while in home cookings, people usually use potato, taro, I've even seen sweet potato, but for us, we just really love potato in this dish. So check out the recipe in the description box. A big thank you for everyone that's supporting us on Patreon. And of course, subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos.